Hi YouTube. Since I'm your official iPod girl, I felt that I should be announcing you that there's a new generation that just came out of nanos. It just came out right now, so I felt as though I should be informing you about it and giving my review about it. So basically, I want to thank all my subscribers again for 26, which makes me a big smile. And so there's a new nano that came out, so it's the fourth generation and it's called the nano-chromatic. So it actually has a new name, so it doesn't get that confusing, because now there's three generations that are called the nano and they're all very different. Well, two are similar, two first ones are similar, but they're just like improvements from the first generation of nanos. They came in 1 gig and 2 gigs, so they came in black and white and they didn't keep that many songs, so they were just the start, because they're like the first nanos ever came out, because before they just had like those big clumpy ones, which were like the only iPods, and they kind of improved those in different generations. So I'm not sure all those different generations, because I wasn't into iPods back then, but so those were ancient. And then they came out with like different types, so they came out with basically, and they were more into white colors back then. So they came out with the video, nano, and shuffle. So those are the three principal categories they separated in at some certain point of time. So I think about in 2002 or under, I'm not sure, probably lower. And before that they made minis, right, that came out, right, that were a spurt of color then, that was a little similar to the metal that they used on the nanos, like those different iPods. They basically made the iPod Shuffle that was white and it looked like a pregnancy test. I used to have one of those, was my first iPod. And then they had the iPod Video, which was a bigger iPod with a big screen, which is basically, well, now for us it is a big screen because we have tiny iPods now. So that's basically like a big one that keeps all your music and your videos and everything. It's just like everything is in there. And then there's the iPod Nano, which is basically just like in the middle, which is this which is just like it keeps your music, and it depends which version of Nano, but it keeps your videos and it just keeps more than shuffle, and it has a screen so you know what you're listening to. And then they just kept on coming up with new ways of making it better, improving it. So they didn't really improve the video. The only thing they did is they made an upgrade, which is basically making it more powerful, more space, more gigabytes, and in the same amount of size. And they made the iPod Classic, which is the same thing. I have it right here, which is, I got the silver one. Which is basically like a metal type of metal thing, which is similar to the iPod Nano that I have. And it has the big clock. So, thank you. Okay, so continuing on that, they made new shuffles, which are tiny, like this one that I kind of ruined a little bit. And they actually changed the color in the new generation. They had a different series of colors, which doesn't really matter because I think that shuffles should not really change models because, you know, you can't really change much in those. And, well, the nanos, they kept on going. They kept in 1 gig, 2 gig, and they came in a certain type of way. You know, they came with the plaque and the white or the black plastic thing over it. And then they came, of course, with these nanos, which this is not mine. And so they came with these nanos, which are basically, they have a specific type of square. It's a little longer than the last one, first generation, and it has on the side, it's rounded. And it came in 2 or 4 gigabytes, and it depended by color. You could only get 2 gigabytes in silver, and 4 in any color, and you can get one that was 8 gig, but that was only in black, and you could get it. And then they came out with the third generation, which is from last year, which is still recent for me, and it's another iPod Nano, they just call it the iPod Nano, which is completely a different concept from the two first generations, and is squared, and it's like 6 to 5 centimeters long from each side, and it basically looks like a square, but it's actually a rectangle because two of the sides are longer, like from 1 centimeter than the other. So they called it the iPod. The iPod Nano 2, and basically it has a plaque at the back too, and they just made that a new fashion. And they made like fade colors for new series of colors for last year. They made it like fade colors, and just not real vibrant colors, you know, that I would like to see. And I think the plaque at the back isn't very necessary or practical because it just gets all scratched and makes you go, oh no, my iPod isn't new or nice anymore. Which, no, I just don't like that. It annoyed me on my classic very much at the back. But that one came in 4 or 8 gigabytes, and the 4 gigabytes in that version was the same price as a 2 gigabyte that came before that, so the prices kept on going lower. So after that, this year, the brand new just came out, a 4th generation, so it's a little different, and I didn't know what they would come out with next, because, you know, they just come out with different things, and I'm happy because I noticed that they actually improved things. They did. They made the vibrant colors I was looking for, you know, those colors you were like, I was like, oh, you know, you can't get a yellow iPod or an orange iPod. They only come in, like, you know, certain colors that, you know, are more towards certain people, normal people. And I was actually happy because it comes in 9 colors, more variety, which is great. And what's also improved about it is the price, again, like any generation, which is affordable and also more gigabytes for the same money that you pay your first generation. And they're pretty fun because they hold video too, and they're longer too, and they're like a more improved of this Nano, which doesn't have video because it has a bigger screen, and you can turn it on this side, and the screen isn't like that, and they use more space, so they don't have the waste of space like here or here a little bit. And what's fun is that if you look here and you compare the one of the nano-chromatic, is that the nano-chromatic is more convex, so it's more like 3D, so your screen is like rounded, which is pretty fun. It's actually a good concept to come up with. It's sure that it's hard to get used to, but I'm pretty sure that I'm going to get more used to that one than the last year's, because last year's was just a completely different type of thing that I can't believe they just called the Nano, which has nothing to do with the first generations. So this is my long history and review of iPods in general. which is yet pathetic, yet intelligent, and yet iPod-like, iPod-ly. And basically, I want one, and I would tell you to get one, because they seem to be fun. But, you know, I save my money, and I'll try, and I'll show it to you. And you check it out in your stores, and yep, I can't wait to check it out. Hi, this was iPodGirl93. Rate, comment, or subscribe, which is always great. And what I said in my other videos, for more mouse fun and more iPod fun now. Yay! Keep up, tune in, it's easy, it's free, and basically just makes me smile even larger. And I have a pretty big smile now.